even in your city, places that you go, people are more apt to greet you and welcome and see you. And so it's just really a great time. I call it the spirit of Christmas. Just the very spirit of Christmas, of just showing kindness and love and fellowship one toward another. We can stand this morning. We're going to open up the famous passage of Scripture of the Christmas story. We'll be turning to Matthew chapter 1 and start reading at verse 18. And we'll have it on the screen for you as well, if you'd like to follow along. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise. And as his mother Mary was engaged to Joseph, before they came together, she was found a child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away properly. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, and saying, Joseph, you the son of David, fear not. Think of you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. She shall bring forth a son, and he shall call his name Jesus. He shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Let's pray, shall we? Lord, we thank you today for your great mercy. Ask your hand to be upon us here today, Lord. We pray every scripture, every word, every song here today would find a place in someone's heart to allow them to grow closer to you, to create a walk with you, that they would desire to be closer to knowing who you are. We thank you today for your love and your mercy. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated this morning. Amen. This story here has been around forever. We can actually say forever. It's been a long time. We've heard it a lot. But sometimes we need to hear different pieces of the story, put it together to make it fit as a nice puzzle to hear the whole story. Last couple of Sundays we've been teaching and talking about different aspects of the Christ story, the birth. It's been actually called the greatest story ever told. I want to add to that this morning, not only is it the greatest story ever told, but it's the greatest story that's ever been unveiled. Another way you could say it was, it's a great story that's been unwrapped. Jesus being wrapped in swaddling clothes. The scripture talks about as him being wrapped, as God being wrapped in swaddling clothes. Isaiah 28:16 says, Behold, I lay in Zion, talking about the Christ child that would come, that he would lay in Zion. The mystery child, the mystery of the unwrapping of who he is, the Christmas story. Let's look at John 1, verses 1 through 5, and just read a couple more passages here. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. And in him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. Verse 14. And the Word was made flesh. This is the Christmas story. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Grace came from heaven. This story is the manifestation of his love. For God so loved the world that he gave. John 3:16. What did he give? That God so loved the world that he gave. He gave his son. He gave himself. Yeah. The unwrapping, the veiling, the unveiling of the gift, the greatest gift ever given to mankind. He enrolled himself and allowed us to see who he was. For God so loved the world that he gave much that he stretched out his arms and died. That's how much he gave. That he loved you and me. So it's more than just the Christmas story. It's the story of the life of Jesus Christ. Of who this one was that we love today. We love him. We honor him. We respect him. What did the angels say about him? Let's look at Luke 1, verse 30 and 31. Now this is important. This is an angel talk. We all like angels, right? We like when the Lord talks. We like when angels talk. And the angel said unto her, "Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God." It doesn't get any better than that. "And behold, thou shalt conceive, and in thy womb, bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus." Not John, not Peter, not Paul, not Frank, not Harvey. Jesus. "Thou shalt call his name Jesus." It was a prophetical name. A name that had meaning, that had definition. Its roots come from the word Jacob. It's a great name. It's a powerful name. There were lots of Jesuses running around in Israel during that time, but this was a special Jesus, because this announcement came from heaven. "Thou shalt call his name Jesus." It was a part of the unveiling of who he was. Angels are important. Luke 2:11, in that same passage there, or that same text, it says, "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." The word Christ means he was the anointed one that was spoken of to come. He's the Christ, the Lord, the Savior. He was the one that was prophesied that he was coming. Moses wrote about him. Isaiah wrote about him. It's a great story. But it was never unveiled or unwrapped until the day of his birth. Today I want to share with you some insight, some details about some of this little story. And we can look at a lot of different aspects of the Christmas story, but I saw something in Scripture that I just really want to share with you that perhaps maybe you've never thought about before. The swaddling clothes. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes. Swaddling clothes in those days were strips of cloth or bands that were used in practice of swaddling or wrapping an infant tightly in cloth, making the child feel secure and warm. This idea became, but behind this was the swaddling or the wrapping, helping the baby make the transition from the nice warm place inside its mother to the outside unknown world. So they would wrap the baby tightly in these bands or strips of cloth and wrap them up really tight so the baby would still feel like he was still in his mother's womb, warm and safe. So he was wrapped in swaddling clothes, helping the transition much, much easier. The child continues to feel the warmth or the snug of the embrace of that safety. So he was wrapped in swaddling clothes. Luke 2:7. Pull that up for me, please. Luke 2:7. "And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn." So he was born in a barn or a stable, and he was wrapped in swaddling clothes. Let's look at verses 11 and 12 of that same chapter. "For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord." Verse 12. "And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. It was prophetical that this baby was going to be wrapped in swaddling clothes. You say, well, how does that make any difference? It makes all of the difference. For one, it was prophetical how that he would be found. It was prophetical where he would be found, what city, what place, the manger, the barn, and that through so much of the details. Now think about this. This is a prophetical statement 1,500 to 2,000 years prior to that he would be found wrapped in swaddling clothes. So, well, what's the big deal? It's a big deal because it was prophetical as the dot in the I and the crossing of the T. It only made sense, as you and I would know, that this baby would be wrapped in swaddling clothes. This baby was born in a very special place. This baby, where it was prophesied that he was born in the city of David, Bethlehem. It is only in Bethlehem that the lambs are wrapped in swaddling clothes. I never said babies, I said lambs. He's on a hillside in Bethlehem. Newborn lambs would be wrapped tightly in swaddling clothes, in specially designated temple clothes that they would be laid then in a manger to keep them contained while they were being examined for blemishes or for sores. And at the appointed time, the shepherds would separate the lambs, selecting only the firstborn males that would be without mark or blemish, and would lead them to Jerusalem. There they would be purchased for people wanting to present a sacrifice before the Lord to atone for their sins. Remember, John the Baptist said when he saw him for the first time, "Behold, the Lamb of God." Jesus comes as the Lamb of God as our Savior. And here at this point of history that I'm making, he was wrapped in swaddling clothes, prophetically speaking, just like a baby lamb. So the wrapping of the swaddling clothes is very important prophetically. When the angels appeared to the shepherds in the field, they told them that they would find the newborn king wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. When they heard that, they knew of only one place where this was done. They knew exactly where this child would be found, because he was going to be swaddled in clothes were only used in this one particular location for one particular purpose. This place was called, there inside, on the side of Bethlehem, was called the Migdol Eder. This was a tower place where the shepherds would go on this particular special hillside. And in this tower, it was a place where the sacrificial lambs that were going to be examined for perfection and be set apart for slaughter only for temple use in the temple to find the perfect lamb for sacrifices. So it was only in this area that they would do this. And Jesus was born right there, where they're all wrapped in swaddling clothes. This Migdol Eder was not just a normal watchtower or tower or an area that was there. This was no ordinary flock of sheep. These sheep were pastured. Ordinarily, flock or just regular sheep are pastured just on barren sheep ground outside of Bethlehem. But these sheep, these were close to town, on the road to Jerusalem, and as they would pass this missional leads, the missional leads, it would lead them to the conclusion that the flocks which were pastured there were watching what's going on, making sure they weren't eaten by a lion or a bear. They were there to guard the sheep that were expecting. So as soon as the sheep would have that little lamb, the shepherd would go immediately, grab the baby lamb, and wrap it up, and guess what? Swaddling clothes. Immediately after they were born, they were wrapped and protected and taken in for inspection to see how perfect they were, make sure there were no blemishes or sores upon this newborn lamb. So you can see the importance of not just the birth, but the place of his birth. Not that just he was just wrapped in swaddling clothes, but it was prophetically meant to be that this baby would be wrapped in swaddling clothes during this specific time. The revelation comes when we know that he was wrapped as a baby and laid in that manger as the Christmas child, as the child of birth, the origin from heaven. But it was all a prophetical story that was being laid out, not just as the Christmas story, but as the story unfolds, John declares him as being this baby, as him being the Lamb of God. He was born in a manger where lambs are to be laid. Now, isn't that amazing? Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. It's amazing how the scripture all fits together. This story this morning is going to unfold before you as you see these children do part of this play. And I just want you to sit and pay attention to what's taking place. In the realization of the baby, of the story, of the angels, of the wise men, of everything that comes in full, all of it was prophetical, and the announcement was made from heaven that God was going to be born on earth. Heaven stopped when this baby was born, and the announcement was made. It wasn't just a baby. This was the baby that was going to be sacrificed. This was the baby that was declared the Lamb of God. And the announcements were made. The only other time in Scripture, and this is just so cool, and this, it just goes on and on. The Bible is so great. We need to read it more often. But the only other time, that Jesus was wrapped was at his death when they wrapped him in linen cloths and they laid him in the tomb. That's the only two times he was wrapped. The first time he was wrapped and came unwrapped and he revealed who he was, telling us that he was the one to come. The second time that he was wrapped, we know it as the Easter story. He was wrapped, laid in the tomb, and this time he arose on the third day, yes, and he proclaimed himself to be the Almighty God. Yes. This is the fulfillment of him literally being Luke 2:11. Right in the middle of the Christmas story, both of these stories are connected. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. On that resurrection morning, he declared who he was. He was the Savior. He was no longer the baby in the manger. He came back and was wrapped twice. The second time he unveiled himself as being the ultimate Savior. Behold, John had cried, the Lamb of God, which takes away the sins of the world. Amen. Let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise this morning. Amen. Amen. Brother, could you catch my wife real quick? Amen. Well, thank you so much for coming and being here this morning. The children are going to do their production now. Amen.
Sorry. Isaiah chapter 9, verse verse 6, for unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. In Luke chapter 2, starting at verse 6, we read the story of the birth of Christ. And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them. And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, fear not. Behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. Thank you. God bless you all. Thank you for coming. I pray you are all well.